Hello and welcome. I am Seth Manfield. We are going to be playing some Pioneer. I'm going to be talking to you all about the deck that I'm choosing for today's video series. Before we get into that, I want to say thank you to Ultimate Guard, my personal sponsor, my team sponsor. Thank you for your support. And then also to Channel Fireball and TCG Player for allowing me to continue to produce this content for you all to watch. You may know that I have done well with Rakdos Vampires. I did win the Pro Tour with that deck. However, okay, I'm going to give you a little inside look into a deck that I was close to actually playing at the Pro Tour. This was more of my own brew, whereas some of my teammates were leading the charge with the Rakdos Vampires, and I kind of hopped onto that. This is a mono green devotion list. So, Leyline of the Guild Pact has not been in the format for that long, right? That is a new card from Murders at Carlov Manor. And it allows us to put in a permanent on turn, before the game starts, a pregame action that has four green devotion symbols. So that is the inspiration for the deck, is that new card. Green devotion had been very strong before the Karn ban. And this list is doing a little bit of wonky stuff. It's not like your typical green devotion deck, but it's got some sweet top end. It's got Ulamog the Ceaseless Hunger and Titan of Industry and Cavalier of Thorns to kind of just go, once you have enough mana, you just start casting really big things. And that's pretty fun. We have also got some Stomping Grounds in the deck, which allows us to access some of these red cards we have in our sideboard. So that gives us a little bit of maneuverability there. You see cards like Quakebringer and Krenko's Buzz Crusher. So we've got those high impact options in the matchups. They're good, like Quakebringer against Amaya, Buzz Crusher against Lotus. I'm only playing six elves because this deck is like it. Well, it really is a house of cards. You don't want too many mana accelerants ramp. But you also, don't want too much top end. So it's a balance. I found six elves to really be that sweet spot. I've also got some cards that help us to draw into some of the late game and smooth out the mana and put green symbols for our Nykthos Shrine to Nyx, of course, one of the signature cards in the deck. So we've got Up the Beanstalk. We've also got Invasion of Ixalan. So we've got the numbers may look strange. Trust me when I say that I've played a decent amount of games with this deck. I'm excited to show off the deck for you all today. Without further ado, let's get into it. All right, we are gonna go ahead and keep this hand. We don't have a ley line, but we do have two elves to kind of get us going. So that's gonna hopefully help us and Up the Beanstalk, an Archdruid's Charm. This is actually a pretty close hand, I think, as to whether to keep or mulligan. We don't know what we're playing against, so we're operating with imperfect information. But knowing that we are playing a deck with Leyline of the Guild Pact does make us more like the mulligan decisions are very important, right, in this deck. And so if we know we're playing against a hand of Fatal Push, probably we would have mulliganed. That's all right. So all right, are we playing against? We may be playing against Rakdos Vampires. Here, let's see. Okay, so we are. This is going to be interesting. So all right, well, we're incentivized to get the Lair of the Hydra out. and then we can either go up the beanstalk or we can land our elves. They are incentivized to kill the elves, which could be good for us. Although they probably wouldn't. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna land our elves here. We can also fight. I don't usually fight with the Archdruid's charm, or punch rather. It's not a fight, it's a punch. But we could do a plus one and deal damage to the Blood Tithe Harvester. Not completely unreasonable. Fable. Okay. All right. We can also kill the shaman if we want. If we want to go the. If we want to go that route with our Archdruid's charm, which it's not a super exciting route to take. So this is tough. Tough spot. Could also get rid of the Fable. Not that excited about that play. Going ahead and finding something like a Cavalier is pretty nice as well. Just to have that in hand, we could potentially play it next turn. I could also just up the beanstalk. See what we draw. I think what I want to do is to just hold up the charm. And that way, if they don't kill our elf, we're more likely to want to get the Cavalier to play. All right, so they pitched a Thoughtseize. That's pretty scary, to be honest with you, because that means one, our opponent doesn't care too much about this Thoughtseize being in hand. And two, they've got good stuff. Okay, so they're gonna fatal push our elf. Was hoping that didn't happen. All right, well, I'm gonna search up. I think I'm gonna go big this time and just hope to get to the mana to be able to play this Titan of Industry. We would need to draw something pretty good here. Okay, Stomping Grounds, not what we wanted. Up the beanstalk, draw. All right. Let's cast our Invasion of Ixalan. Looks like our opponent may be having some connection difficulties. All right, let's see what we find off of this invasion. We're probably looking for something like Cavalier, but a troll. I think we have to take this troll. All right, let's grab that. And then pass. So we're going to take another 5 down to 5 down to 7. So we're dead to a decent amount of stuff here for sure. Not looking in a great spot. Maybe should have mulliganed our opener if we knew we were up against a multiple fatal push draw from to get rid of our elves, but let's see if they have a follow-up. Oh, it could be a Vein Ripper, which probably just does it here. Yeah. So they get to play their Vein Ripper. And that's it for game one. Let's see what we want to do after sideboard. So I think we want answers to spheres. So we're going to board in Boseiju. Troll is good. Actually, Troll and Up the Beanstalk, I think, are pretty good here in this matchup. We don't want to do anything too crazy. Although, as I say that, I'm actually going to shave on some elves. I think because elves, while very good on turn one, if they live, it's also a bit of a gamble. And we saw that in the last game. We saw how we play an elf, and if they die, then it's pretty bad. Also, I'm just like, it's kind of, sometimes it's hard to cut cards from this deck. And I think in this version of the deck, because we have ley lines, like, we're just really hoping to get Leyline Nykthos out. And then also, and we weren't able, we just had the Nykthos that last game. So yeah, I'm now in the mulliganing mindset because I know that our opponent doesn't have answers to enchantments in their deck. So once the ley line is out, then, you know, there's not much that our opponent can do about it. And so we can make more appropriate decisions. We're going to keep no ley line. We do have some decent stuff going on in this hand, though. So sometimes we do have to keep hands like this. I am going to keep this because also keep in mind we're against a deck with a bunch of Thoughtseize effects, and this hand is good against Thoughtseize because we've just got, we can keep playing things, right? Like if they get rid of our Haven or if they get rid of our Invasion or our Cavalier, like all of that stuff is somewhat replaceable. Okay, Oath of Nissa, that's not bad. I think I want a Wolf Willow Haven here, and sometimes it's tough figuring out which land to put the Wolf Willow Haven on. I'm gonna put it on the castle here because we might end up activating the lair. We also might end up activating the castle, so that's why I say it can be a little bit challenging to manage that. Harvester, that's fine. So we're definitely going to want to make sure we continue to hit our land drops. So hopefully we can land this Cavalier next turn. That's a nice pickup. So now that we have that, Nykthos. If we oathed. So Oath is a little bit of an aggressive play. I'm just going to Up the Beanstalk, see what we draw, because that's going to give us more information. Okay, so we drew a Wolf Willow Haven. In that case, I'm just going to put a Wolf Willow Haven on this castle. It's going to set us up really nicely for next turn. next turn is going to be our big turn. So this was just our turn three. They're going to take their turn three. So they might get a Vein Ripper down, which would be probably worst case scenario. Fable is beatable here. Because now we're going to get to do our fun stuff. I hope you all are excited, because I know I am for this next turn. Oh, that's even... Yeah, now we're really cooking. Now we are really cooking. Okay. I think I want to start here. Okay, so we're definitely gonna tap our Castle Garenbrig. And do we want to? I mean, the Oath of Nyssa is kind of like a free play almost. So yeah, I'm gonna Oath here. Get another green permanent into play. Probably just want to take the Boseiju for our land drop. The Old Growth Troll has some appeal as well. But yeah, I'm just going to take the Boseiju. Okay. All right, so now we get to activate our Nykthos. It's going to give us 4 mana. We can play this Kiora. And I am just going to untap the Castle Garenbrig. We're going to get to draw 2 cards off of this Cavalier of Thorns. Unfortunately, our Cavalier of Thorns did whiff, so it's a good thing that we just kept this Boseiju around. Off that Oath of Nyssa. And we've still got gas, right? We've got a Beanstalk, and we've got, more importantly, this Invasion of Ixalan. We've got another Nykthos, so we could really start to do even more fun stuff next turn. Okay, that's fine. Liliana of the Veil. Make us sack our Cavalier. So we can actually get back another Cavalier, which I'll do. It's a very solid card to have here. We can cast it next turn. They also can't get rid of our Kiora. They can put it to 1. So that is pretty annoying. Okay. So we play the Beanstalk, it means more draws, another green. Mana Symbol out there. Not entirely sure if I should or not. But I'm going to. Can't help myself with the extra value. And now we go activate our Nykthos. Make 7 mana, Cavalier of Thorns. This is going to draw us 3 cards. Grab a Castle Garenbrig here. Oh, you know what? That was a mistake on my part. I thought we had a forest out, which we don't. So I probably should have grabbed the Stomping Grounds. It's okay, though. So now I think we get rid of our Kiora. We're gonna untap this Nykthos. Make 8 mana. And with that 8 mana, we've got even more options. I'm thinking about just playing another Cavalier, to be honest, although I would do that with the Archdruid's Charm. Although I guess I can Nykthos. Actually, we can Ulamog here, can't we? So if I play if I play second Nykthos, well, actually this is free. The ley line is free, so let's play that. Because we're gonna get all that mana back when we go for our Nykthos. So we play Nykthos, then we make 14 mana. Search our library for a card with our Archdruid's Charm. And I am just going to get the Ulamog. We're going to Ulamog here, and yeah, that's game. That is game right there. So we go to a game 3. Whew. All right. That's how we do it. That's how we do it with this deck. On the draw, do we want to change anything? I mean, I don't think so. But it is scary being on the draw. The good news, I guess, kind of good news, we haven't had the ley line. So here is the ley line in the Nykthos, although sometimes you get these weird spots because obviously we have too many Nykthoses in our hand. I'm still gonna keep because of the power of Nykthos plus Leyline, but we're gonna have to hopefully draw something decent. That's not bad. The Titan of Industry here. Okay. All right, game on. Yep. The next turn is the turn where we get to go. Activate Nykthos. We can make 4 mana. Play Kiora. Untap Nykthos. Yeah, that's not gonna do much. So I think what we are gonna end up doing is just playing another ley line out that we just drew. So that's gonna give us a lot of extra mana for turn 4. And we don't actually care that much about Lily. We can just discard an excess Nykthos. All right. So I could also go Kiora plus Wolf Willowhaven. Feel like getting this ley line out though has more value. So I'm just gonna play that. And then on this following turn, we're gonna get to really have fun. I can probably, I mean, if we don't get like Thoughtseize, we're hoping not to for our hand to get messed with beyond the Liliana that we know about. Right. Well, I not happy about that, but it is something that I was aware could happen. And let's see what they do with this Liliana of the Veil here. So they are gonna make us discard. Question is, do we want this Wolfalo or not, kind of? Wolfalo Haven, that is. Or do we want second Nykthos, another Nykthos, which could be pretty good for sure. The Haven could also be valuable, you know. Tough one. Because both add extra mana in the long term, which is pretty nice. The Haven can become a 2/2, which isn't irrelevant. I'm gonna discard the Haven. Yeah. I am gonna go with that one. Okay, that's a nice pickup. That is pretty nice. But how to navigate? I think I will. Well, the thing is we are also incentivized to get this Liliana off the board. Because it's pretty annoying. And the ultimate is pretty scary. Although they could have a fatal push. If I activate a lair and it gets fatal push, that's pretty brutal. And they did discard one, so they could have another one. Yeah. That's tricky. That's very tricky. Right, I'm gonna hope that we can deal with the Liliana in some other way, I think, and go Kiora. If we get to draw an Ul'amog, for instance, to get rid of it, it's pretty great. Yeah, so we're gonna make our mana. We're gonna get some draws here, which is pretty good. So we can. Untap our Nykthos. Let's do that. Twelve mana. So we're gonna get, I guess one draw plus another land, which could be valuable. Okay, another Kiora. That's actually not the worst. And a lair. Okay. So if we want to, we can play this Kiora and untap one of these lairs to try to get in this turn. So I think I am going to do that. So yeah, we play a Kiora. Untap a lair. Play a Nykthos. And make 14 mana. So I mean, we're hoping this doesn't get fatal pushed, but so this is a 13-13 Lair of the Hydra. I could actually go face. Going face would put our opponent down to put our opponent down to four. Then they would presumably plus the Liliana. Doesn't seem great. I think I just kill Liliana. Just make sure that's gone. And turns out they did not have a second fatal push, so that line ended up kind of being the best of both worlds in a way. Archfiend of the Dross. Okay. Oh, I am realizing I'm low on time. Interesting. Didn't realize that. It's okay. Yeah, so this was a good draw. I'm gonna try to play faster. And okay, that's game. GG. So we're on the draw. Without Nykthos or a ley line. I think this hand is a mulligan. There's some stuff going on here with the elf into Haven, but our deck can win off mulligans, and this hand is definitely better. We shouldn't need our red mana game one, so we'll just put the Stomping Grounds on the bottom of our deck, start with the ley line of the Guild Pact. And see what our opponent is up to. Okay, well, if it's Amalia, that is a challenging matchup, especially game one. Especially, and if they have a good draw, we'll just have to see. Our draw at the moment isn't great, of course. We're looking for some action. It is Amalia, as is expected, based off of that turn one Razor Verge and a Lunark Veteran. Right. Well, if they start comboing, I am willing to just pack it. I don't need to see the Amalia combo in full display. They've got a Fauna Shaman, so they've got presumably the ability to do it if they have another creature, which I guess it's not a complete given that they do have another creature. We're hoping that they don't. So, yeah, I guess I could have. No, there's nothing. Maybe I could have activated the lair for a little bit of damage here. Nothing we can do this turn. Next turn, we would be able to make six, seven, eight. We still don't have Ulamog for next turn. And so yeah, they've got it here. They're just gonna pitch him on pitch Lunark Veteran rather. Amalia and go crazy, huh? Yeah. All right. So the Quakebringer is really our main plan here. We've got two of them. So we're gonna bring them in and hope to find them. We do have a few different ways of finding those. And as far as what we're taking out of the deck, I could also board in Chandra's. Chandra is weird. Like, it's minus three could be relevant in some spots. I think I'd take out the old growth trolls. Yeah, I suppose on the play, Chandra. Chandra does have some value. Up the beanstalk isn't really what we're trying to do, because this isn't really a grindy matchup per se. So these are all cards that, we can hope to draw our Stomping Grounds, or Leyline also gives us red mana. So it may look like, hey, we don't have that much red, but yeah, we can do it. I'm taking out some Titans. Like, I'm taking out just some of the non-interactive stuff. Chandra, to be honest, I know that this is not a great matchup for Mono Green Devotion, okay? As we could see game one, we don't have interaction really in our main deck for what Amalia is doing. But, I mean, some of these high impact cards are. We can find them. We've got Archdruid's Charms. We've got. It's kind of also a matter of time. Like, do we have the ability to do it? So here, this is a weird one, right? Because we've got the double ley line. We don't have the Nykthos though. So you don't know. I mean, that's if we had a Nykthos, the hand would be really good. I think on like six, I would keep this, and I would just gamble on either drawing Nykthos or a way to find Nykthos. On seven, I am leaning towards this just being a mulligan because we might not get there and then we just don't have a game. All right, well. No ley line is rough, and no red source is kind of rough because we can't. I guess we do have the oath for the Chandra, so we can Chandra. All right, let's try this. We're gonna put back the Titan and hope that this Chandra is. So yeah, another source of red mana are the Oath of Nissa's. Okay, so we found the Quakebringer, but in a spot where I don't know that we take it because we do need lands. And I think our plan is now to just Chandra pretty quickly. Probably not until turn four still for this Chandra. But I do want to land. So I'm gonna take this lair. Without the ley line or stomping grounds, the Quakebringer isn't really coming together this game. So you do have to be, we do have to be wary of that. They could also have discard stuff. They could have random interaction for what we're doing. We don't know. All right, we're just gonna put this Haven on a forest, and we have a Chandra turn four. They might have the turn three combo though. If they just naturally have the goodies, then in this case, a Wild Growth Walker or ability. Yeah, basically just a Wild Growth Walker is what they need to have in hand. Which obviously is a possibility. It is very much a possibility. Alrighty. Yeah, no real way to get up to 5 mana this turn for a Cavalier. Unfortunately. So we will be setting up to hope to have another turn after this. Do we want another Chandra? Is the question. Could also just take a ley line. Second Chandra isn't super exciting. Also, if they have something like a Skyclave Apparition and they see the Chandra, they might just get rid of our Oath, which would be kind of a disaster. I'm gonna take a ley line here. Alright, so no Wild Growth Walker so far. Interesting. So they've got the ability to protect all of this stuff. So in this case, against the Selfless Savior version of the Amalia deck, not in love with the spot. Okay. So let's make some mana with our Nykthos. That's 5 mana. So I can either Chandra minus, though, isn't doing us that much, is it? We can Cavalier. Could also... Ugh. Yeah, this Chandra plan isn't actually... It's not even close to what we want it to be now. So if we Chandra, yeah, no, it's not gonna do it. I guess I Cavalier. But I don't feel good about this situation. Now I really don't feel good about this situation. All right. We are probably going to lose this. Like I said, this is a challenging matchup, so it shouldn't be that surprising. I'll just evolution, find Wild Growth Walker, concede. Alright, we do get to play this match. And our opening hand, we've got an elf into a charm. Elf into a charm. We do have a Nykthos. All right, I'm going to keep this. It's not amazing. We can charm and find an old growth troll on turn two. And in this type of game, the troll could be pretty good because we're just trying to get green devotion symbols into play for our late game stuff. Khetria Triome. That's an interesting land to start off with here. All right. I could just do it right now. I don't know what I'm super worried about. So maybe they have like a weird counter spell type of thing, like a spell pierce negate type card. If that were to happen, I'd be super upset about losing this troll. So I'm just going to grab the troll right now. I think that makes sense. And jam it and then play a Nykthos. Because I think they might have Leyline Binding, which would be a reason to keep this Boseiju. I could have also gotten a Cavalier, I guess, with the charm. Maybe should have thought about that one more. But this way we have more mana for this next turn, so we get to do pretty fun things. All right, so let's see, we can make 4 mana. Board wipes, spring to light. Definitely different cards that we need to be thinking about. Because we can actually go troll into Titan this turn. But, like I said, those cards that I just mentioned are pretty scary. It may be fine to actually play the Boseiju out, now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, I think I'm just going to take a more conservative line. Because I don't want to get blown out by a board wipe. I mean, it's still kind of a blowout. They get rid of our trolls, although I guess it depends what card they're using to do it with. And I don't really see a way around it at this point. So we're going to play a troll and just a troll. I guess I could have had a titan out as well. So now that I'm thinking about it, maybe it's a little silly not to have done it. Okay, tap land so they don't have a 5 mana play. Although having the titan here is pretty good. Like, it gives us a nice insurance plan. Also, we can Ulamog next turn. So, yeah, I'm pretty happy about this. We can do a few things. I could just force them to have to chump with their Sylvan Caryatid. But I think we want to Ulamog. Seven. Yeah. Big bad Ulamog, and we get to take out two of these lands, which I will be doing. The question is which ones to get rid of. White. I could get rid of the two blue sources. Also get rid of the black. I'll get rid of the Rogrin and the Kettra without thinking about it too much. Guess this is only a 2/2 layer, so they just have a clean block on it, but I'll still activate it. Make them make the block. Now we are kind of in the same. Oh, well, they should have made the block. Now we are kind of in the same spot as. I mean, they could bring to light for a sweeper like a Sunfall type card. Wow. That's so sick that they actually have it. However, we have close to lethal off the lair, but I guess not lethal. Frustrating, very frustrating. Wait a second. Yeah, there are four. I was about to say, is there some way that this is lethal? All right, well, so this was the idea behind keeping the Titan in hand, is that it could potentially get us out of this, right? See if we draw a land, we can play it this turn. Nykthos, I mean, not Nykthos, Kiora, rather. Kiora, untap, Woofalo Haven. Don't think we untap the Woofalo Haven. Maybe we do. We can also sacrifice the Woofalo Haven. Which puts a 2/2 onto the battlefield. But at the same time, it makes us further away from this Titan of Industry. So I am just leaning towards keeping the Kiora. At 7 loyalty. and passing turn. So they get to make their 6/6 incubate. Man, it's pretty sick that turn that they Sunfall. They also had Watery Grave, untapped land. But this is getting back and forth. They've got a lot of cards, but because we got rid of those two lands, look, they're stuck on land. They're missing land drops. They can't just cleanly attack away and kill Kiora with an attack. Awaken. So that gets a land. Mountain. Okay. Well, if they just pass, then we do get to play our Titan, presumably. If we want to. Oh my gosh. Well, that's very annoying. So that's a big wrench in our plan. Now our Titan is gone. Okay. It's an interesting pickup. Could just play Invasion here. That's what I'm leaning towards. Play Invasion, see what we find. Spin the wheel a little bit. Otherwise, we'd be activating the lair, but I don't think that's what we want to do this turn. Okay, Cavalier of Thorns. That is pretty good here. I could also take an oath, which gives me redraws. I don't know. So Cavalier, there are pros and cons to the Cavalier here. The good news is if we play it, we draw a card off Kiora. The bad news, if we have to minus our Kiora, then we're probably going to lose it next turn. I am going to take the Cavalier. I think we just have to play it. I mean, we don't have to play it, but I think it makes sense to play it. Spin the wheel. Draw a card. Okay. Another lair. And a Castle Garenbrig. All right. Wow, untapped land. So now they could potentially bring to light. Presumably, yeah, we're playing against a bring to light deck. We have to be. Another interesting spot we have found ourselves in. Another interesting spot. I would like to keep that QR around, but it seems like it's going to be hard. Because if I chump block with the Cavalier, I guess I'd be getting back an Oath of Nyssa from the graveyard or an Archdruid's Charm. Okay, well, that's not the card I was expecting to get cast. Let's just put it that way. But okay, what does this one do? All right, well, they're not doing anything. So here we go. Let's see what we draw. That is a sweet draw. That is a very good draw. Okay, so now we have Nykthos plus Castle Garenbrig. Here it is, Titan of Industry. Huge, huge, massive draw there. So we are going to be destroying and creating. So we can destroy the incubate token and make a 4/4. We're going to draw two more cards. Two lands, that's still fine. We can untap our Nykthos. Make a lot of mana. And this is just going to be an attack at our opponent directly. And maybe lethal. We'll see what they have. Lightning Helix, so they gain 3 life off the Helix, and then they can double chump, and yep. So they are gonna go to 1 here off this attack. Still feel very good about the spot. Alrighty, cool game there. Cast Ul'mog, got our board wiped, played a few more turns. Like, those are the situations that can happen with this deck. Fun stuff. We didn't see a lot of enchantments, but I think they should be there. So the Boseiju probably should come in. We want our Up the Beanstalk for these longer games. Chandra. Chandra can do some stuff. It's another angle of attack. I'm not completely sure if it's worth it, though. To be honest. Interesting matchup. I'm thinking about cutting some elves, to be honest. Yeah, I think I'm on that plan on the draw. We're just going to have a bunch of bigger cards in our deck. Higher impact stuff. I'll keep one elf in. This is kind of random, to be honest, but we saw cards like Lightning Helix. I am scared of elves dying, and we drew an elf, which is just peachy. So we can go elf into Haven, put down our ley lines. Let's gamble. This is a very gambly hand. I'm not sure if the keep is correct. I will say that. I will admit that. And I will still keep the hand and see what happens. We are looking for a Nykthos, or an Archdruid's Charm, or an Oath, or anything that can draw us into a Nykthos. Okay. I just can't help but laugh about that. So I guess our opponent's not playing Bring to Light, or I don't know what they're playing, but yeah. I boarded out all but one elf against a five-color deck. We started with Elvish Mystic, and then it got Fatal Pushed. I am stating facts that happened. And I think they are comical. Maybe we will just say draw Nykthos. How would that be? I can answer that. It would be quite nice. It would be very, very sweet and feel good. And we would probably just do, ooh, so draw Nykthos, activate it, make 9 mana, play Kiora, untap it. Play Cavalier, play Old Growth Troll, draw 2 more cards, do whatever. All right, that all sounds good. Let's do that. Let's try to do that this turn, shall we? And Nykthos. Okay. All right, not a Nykthos, but I think I'll just play the Troll. I don't know really what type of removal they've got now, because I guess technically, we have not seen Leyline Binding. We know they've got Yorion. That turn, I could have also gone Kiora plus Up the Beanstalk. Vanishing Verse, okay. Or no, this Consecrate card. Sure. I saw the white-black being tapped, and I was thinking, oh, it's a Vanishing Verse, because they're probably playing a Bring to Light deck. But I was wrong about that. And I just play the Troll to get some pressure, right? We can start attacking with it. All right, so they're tapping out. Tapping all but one mana for Fable. And they analyze the pollen. Right. Let's see. Kiora. Not what we wanted, but we'll play one. And we'll play the beanstalk. Do we attack with our troll? Don't know actually if we do. Guess I'm not going to. Because, I mean, it's a blocker, right? So it forces them to get rid of it, kind of. If they kill the troll, we don't really care that much. So they do a Vanishing Verse in their deck. So this is a Niv-Mizzet deck, I think. A Niv-Mizzet deck. Five color Niv. Maybe with Bring to Light as well. That would make sense. Kind of. Trying to put the pieces together. All right, this is going to be Niv-Mizzet, I'm guessing. Yeah. All right. Well. Yeah, so we see Wandering Mind and Bring to Light. Think I'm actually going to attack with the troll here. Just to kind of see what they do. I was hoping they would block, because that would give us more mana. We get to draw two cards off this Cavalier. Now there's the Nykthos. Multiple Nykthoses. Okay. Lots of mana for next turn, so it's gonna be interesting now. This game is interesting. They have the Bring to Light. What can they bring to light for? Oh, sorry about that. Yep. Yep. Tybalt. Okay. All right, so they're going to use that Tybalt as a removal spell. They want to get rid of. I was thinking they would wanted to get rid of Archaeora, but they're not doing that. So to be honest, I'm not sure what the plan was there. But we get to do a lot of stuff here. A lot of stuff. I mean, we get to kind of go crazy. Yeah, like this turn is pretty ridiculous. In fact, there's a decent chance we just win this turn. I'm gonna start with a Cavalier. We're drawing two cards. Yeah, so that's the card we really wanted, was the Ul'mog. It's fine. We bricked off that trigger. I guess I'd play a Beanstalk here. Why not? Draw even more cards. Three mana. That's a lot. That is a lot of mana. We can kind of sequence this how we choose. I think I'm gonna start with Titan. So we did that. Play another Titan. This is just to really get everything they have off the board, pretty much. We're just gonna get rid of that treasure token. And we still have our land drop, so we're not worried about mana. Make a bunch more mana. 31 mana. And we can just close the game out with an Ul'mog here. And we just have a lair activation, which is pretty clean. They don't have any mana to speak of. So I don't really see a way out for our opponent. GG. All right, let's take the play here. And I'm gonna mull this. We have an Elvish Mystic. But yeah, that's about it. Like, we don't have a ley line or an Ikthos or really much going on in this hand. This one I like a lot more, so we'll keep it. Tough choice is what we get rid of. So I think we want the charm. Do we want the beanstalk? Maybe. I might just get rid of the haven. Yeah. That's tough. I think it's between Wolf Willow Haven and Up the Beanstalk here. Not really knowing what our opponent play like if we knew our elf was gonna die, that would certainly change it. Kamano. Okay, interesting. So now we're really hoping to hit land. This, there it is. And I'm just gonna run out the Up the Beanstalk draw card. We don't really know if they're gonna kill our elf or not, or what. Like, just having more information of what we're gonna draw off the Up the Beanstalk is pretty nice. Legion Loyalist. So yeah, this is red aggro for sure. All right. Well, it's an interesting pickup. Think I'm gonna run out. Run out the invasion. Just take a land off of it. It's kind of hoping to just naturally draw the Nykthos there off the invasion, because then we could have used the charm for something else. We could also draw it off of an oath if we do oath again. But we're under pressure, so we're taking a lot of damage here. And I'm just not gonna block, so I'm taking six. So yeah, I think I oath. See what we oath into. I'm hoping for it to be a Nykthos. Because that'd be kind of fun. Instead, it's a Titan of Industry. So we're definitely not gonna shock ourselves off the stomping ground. And unfortunately, nothing great to do at the moment. So we might just lose the game here. Robber of the Rich. So this is, ugh, so much damage. I mean, I could. No, I'm just gonna end up taking this all, right? I guess I could block one point of damage. These all have, I mean, blocking one point of damage could be relevant, right? So we'll put that there. We're gonna use the charm to get Nykthos. Does look like I may be dead to this Atarka's command, so this is gonna pump everything up. So we're just gonna have to. I may be dead, like I said, but we'll go ahead and kill something. I guess I'm going to one. So we need to draw the Nykthos now. And we did not. If I drew Nykthos, I could have come back in potentially to that game, because we get to, yeah, I mean, we get to gain life, make a dude, and yeah, we're in a nice spot. Okay, but we know what we're playing against, and I do feel like I got a little bit unlucky there, and with some of those triggers, We definitely want maximum trolls here, I believe. Up the beanstalk. Not really a priority in the matchup. I'm not going to really do too much. I think this should be a pretty decent matchup for us overall. Okay, so we have Leyline, no Nykthos. We get to start with Leyline and an Elvish Mystic. Cavaliers as our top end. Ah, that's close. I think I'm mulliganing this one. No Nykthos. No access to it. The thing is we do just have to go fast in this matchup. I like this hand more. It's possible actually I should have taken out maybe an Ulamog. Taking out one Ulamog, I probably should have done that in hindsight. But do we keep this one or do we put it on the bottom? So we get to go Oath of Nissa. So Nissa, we're looking for Nykthos, of course. We're gonna have the ley line out. Yeah, I guess I'll put the Ulamog back, although I'm actually not confident it's correct to do so. It's a little bit dependent. Like if we knew what we were gonna oath into. Like if I knew I was gonna hit a Nykthos, I might just put back the troll, right? But if we don't hit the Nykthos, we may need the troll. That is the dilemma. So here it's either an elf or a stomping ground. I think I'm gonna take stomping ground because if the elf gets hit with something like a play with fire, that's gonna really mess us up. Whereas now we can at least go stomping ground next turn. Turn three, old growth troll for sure. So we at least have that turn three troll to maybe buy us a little bit of time, and that's a nice pickup for sure. So now everything changes. Everything changes when we draw that card. So we're gonna take some heat. Ooh. Okay, Cindervines. Cindervines is a scary one for sure. It can blow up our ley line. So we're just gonna take this moment to play our Cavalier while we can. And just grab another layer of the Hydra, I think. Maybe I should have grabbed the Forest. No, I think. Yeah, maybe I should have grabbed the forest. This is fine. We'll see what they end up doing this turn. We've got that charm in the graveyard. So if our cavalier dies, we can get that back. Although. Yeah. The Kamanos are scary because they also can exile the cavalier. I am going to block this. Block. Monstrous Rage. Cavalier does die, though, so we get to get back our charm. Which is pretty good. Quite good. So, we can make 5 mana with our Nykthos. So, five. If I use three of it. For a search. Yeah, I guess I don't really want to use three of it for a search, do I? So, well, we're gonna play troll. So yeah, I'm gonna play troll and Castle Garenbrig. Then the question is, what do we do with this Archsteward's Charm? We could use it as a removal for either the Cinder Vines or the Swift Spear. We can also use it to search our deck for something. I think that's what I'm going to do. Going to get a Titan of Industry. I guess was this? I don't know if this was right. I'm not confident that it's right. Definitely interesting choice. Because we could have with that charm, like any of the options were possible. We can't just pass because we're gonna lose the mana from the Nykthos. But other than that, I think, I mean, now that I'm thinking about it, yeah, I'm happy I did it. Because if we're able to untap and play Titan of Industry, it of course has a huge impact on this board. It looks like we're going to be able to. Right, so Cinder Vine's gone down to 11. Swift Spear cast as well. That's a big Swifty. So we're gonna have to block here with our troll, I believe, when our opponent attacks, assuming they attack. Their last card could be at Atarka's command. Could be a few different things. But they're not attacking. Okay. That's also seems like it would make some sense. They could command to stop us from getting life as well. We may end up racing, so I think I'm gonna attack with the troll. Yeah, let's start with an attack before this Wisp Spear grows. Okay. So here it is, Titan Industry, and I think we want to make a dude for sure, and then probably gain the life. Yeah. I'm happy with that. And we're looking like we're gonna push to a game three. We've got these Lair of the Hydras. We can start firing those up. I think I'll hold up the Boseiju in case we want to channel it. Sure, Cinder Vines. Definitely good to know about the Cinder Vines. It does mean that our ley lines are more vulnerable. And it's probable actually that I want this other Boseiju. I'm going to take out all the mean stocks being on the draw. It's just too slow. Not doing a ton of sideboarding, although, I kind of wanted to take out Ulamog. I'm just not sure what I would bring in, because it's basically just that Chandra, which has, you know, not a ton of applications. Not really great. I guess I do want, I can play a Beanstalk. So, I mean, it's not, the sideboard is not built for this matchup, but we naturally have a decent matchup because we've got life gain, we've got explosiveness, and you can tell how game one, we very easily could have won had things been a little bit different with some of those triggers to try to look for that Nykthos. Alright, this is a hand, like I said, our ley lines are vulnerable. I think we have to keep this kind of hand. We didn't see a ton of creature removal. We saw the play with fires, but I think they're leaning on other cards. So it's not a guarantee that our elves are going to die. Opponent did mulligan down to 6, so yeah, we'll see what happens here. Could be one of those play draw things where this hand looks a lot better than the play, naturally. Not much we can do about that. Oh, wow. So they're actually just scrying now for land. Did find the land, notably. I think we want to play Kiora. And Elvish Mystic as well. And if they start attacking the Kiora, we're not entirely sad about that. Because it means they're not going directly at our face. Alright. So let's see where this attack is going. Directly at us. Alright, no blocks. Monstrous Rage. Okay. Alright, so we're taking decent chunk there. Decent chunk. Mm-mm. So we can play Cavalier. I could get aggressive and Oath and try to find Nykthos. But I'm thinking I should probably just play the Cavalier here. And yeah. I'm gonna play Castle Garenbrig. Also, we can actually potentially play both here. Yes, so this is. We want to hit a green land, like a forest, or another Castle Garenbrig, kind of. Because then we can play off this Cavalier. Because then I can play an Old Growth Troll the same turn. Found Nykthos. I don't think I want to shock for Stomping Grounds. I could shock for Stomping Grounds in order to play Troll. Which isn't the worst. I mean, it's another big blocker. But Nykthos is valuable as well, certainly. Don't think they have that much direct damage. So actually, I'm gonna be greedy here and just go for this troll. And pass turn. Land. Reckless Bushwhacker. That's not that scary. Not that scary. Lots of things we can do. Probably we start with the Oath. If we hit a Nykthos, it opens up a lot of options. Right. Cavalier of Thorns, we'll take that one. And play Cavalier. All right, so we're gonna take this Nykthos for sure. And what happens if I do shock again, activate Nykthos? We can make a bunch of mana and then go find, like, yeah, I think that's good, right? We can go find, like, a Titan. And then play it. Got enough mana to do all of that. So 13 mana. Search. We will find a Titan of Industry. I can also play another Kiora. Which is going to give us even more mana. And it's going to, yeah, really just open this game up wide open. So we play a Titan. And yeah, our opponent's just going to concede. All right.